did Gucci Man walk up to Primetime, or did he get dropped off? Like, I don't understand. At this time, Trap House, you know, they was playing, we was playing Trap House all the time. Like, he had songs out. So I'm like, okay, well, yeah, you know, Bumpy, yeah, of course. Take Gucci Man home. Welcome to the Sexy Nights with Silver Knight. We got bottles of wine and cheese and crackers on the inside of the building. We're at Vinoteca on Highland, by the way. Appreciate y'all letting me, you know, do a little bit of this these stories with Silver Knight here. So appreciate that. So I got another story, man. I got another one. I'm gonna tell you about the time that I took Gucci Mane home. I can't neither confirm or deny if he was drunk or whatever, but we both were definitely having a couple of sips that night. We had a few libations. I was working at Club Primetime, which at the time was one of the biggest spots, like, period, for like all the new music. Probably had, you know, upwards of, you know, 2,500 people every time I DJed Fridays and Saturdays. It was the spot, and I was one of the, you know, main. I was the main DJ at the time. So, and this is on the east side, Covington Highway. So, you know, we had, especially on Saturdays, we'll always have these different concerts. You know, Rick Ross has come through there, Shawty Lowe, he's come through there, RIP. Who else we had come? I mean, you name it, they've been through there. Project Pac, even Puff Daddy came one time. So, you know, of course, Gucci Man has come through there before. We always played this music, and me and Gucci Man had got cool, you know, just from him coming up there. And I was pretty much cool with anybody that would come through the door because they got to come and rock with the DJ. You got to come in and respect the DJ. So, you know, he would come up there pretty much, you know, kind of all the time, perform, we're paying, come, you know, perform, do a concert. So this one night, it was an off night, and I believe it was a Thursday night. It was Wednesday or Thursday night because it wasn't as packed as it usually is. And it was kind of like one of those off nights. I think the club was trying to get this Thursday night going, so I was there on a Thursday night, which was unusual. I'm looking around, DJing, you know, we doing our thing, and I look back, and it's Gucci Man. Okay. So I'm like, oh man, you know, what's up, man? Oh, you came to, you know, show it up, show love, appreciate you. You know, we chopping it up, kicking it, you know, he by himself. He by himself. So, you know, as we kicking it, you know, hour or so go by, we drinking and you know, I'm playing music, whatever. He goes, hey, Silver, and you mind, you know, taking me home at the end? Mind taking me home at the end of the night? I'm like, yeah, you know, cool. You know, one no Uber, one no Lyft. You know, this time, you know, you might call the cab. So when he asked me, he was dead serious. Like Gucci was like, hey, Silver, I'm gonna need you to take me home. All right. Now I'm thinking in my mind, did Gucci Man walk up to Primetime, or did he get dropped off? Like, I don't understand. At this time, Trap House, you know, they was playing, we was playing Trap House all the time. Like, he had songs out. So I'm like, okay, well, yeah, you know, Bumpy, yeah, of course. Take Gucci Man home. So I finished DJing, he wasted the end of my set. I had to go get paid and everything. And he's like, all right, come on, man, let's, you know, I'll take you to the crib. He jumps in the car, walk out, jump in the car. So we go, he's like, man, look, you know, while we on the way home, man, you mind stopping at this Waffle House real quick, you know, so we can get something to eat. I got you. Yeah, of course. you got to do it, you know, you got to spin it, you know what I'm saying? You got to sniff it and then spin it. Oh, I'm not that good. I'm getting better. And then you got to, like, he could have told me to take him to Athens. It didn't matter. It was Gucci Mane. So I say that so proper. Gucci Mane. Gucci Mane. It was Gucci. So it was Gucci, man, you know what I'm saying? So we go to Waffle House. Everybody know, what's up, Gucci? You know, all the people behind. So we sit there, we eat. You know, I think at the time I had like the chicken with the smothering cover. I forget what Gucci had. So, you know, we eat and he's like, all right, man, you know, we ready. And then we jump in the car, man. And probably like 5 minutes away, like kind of in the hood, we go down this little block and he got a house over there, man. He's like, you can drop me right here, man. It was a bunch of like dope old schools in the yard with big rims. And I drop him off, man. And hey, I Miss Parker. And I drop him off, man. It was so crazy. Now that I think about it, I was like, yo, Gucci Mane came up to prime time, and I took him to Waffle House and took him home. That's still crazy to me, man. So yeah, I drove Gucci Mane home. You already know what it is, the stories with your man DJ Silver Knight, the party fanatic. Make sure you follow me on all social media, especially Instagram, and that's where I live and play for real, at DJ Silver Knight, that's Knight with the K, and DJSilverKnight.com. All right, let's go. It's called In Sheep's Clothing.
Yep, Black Winemaker coming Black out winemaker, of Oregon.
What she said, all of what she said. Introduce yourself, tell her where we at.
Hey guys, I'm Blue, we're at Enoteca.
This is not this.
No. But yeah, you should definitely check him out, Andre Mack, Black winemaker, making his wines out of Oregon and Washington, living in Brooklyn, doing it big.
Big. B-I-G.
There you go, babe.
Well, thank you.
Enjoy, you're welcome.
All right.